YouTube, my name is Mesa Sean, and welcome back to another Destiny 2 video. Alright folks, we're going to tackle two topics today. One, we're going to talk all about pinnacle sources. It's really confusing right now because there was a number of mislabeled things in your directory in terms of, well, what's dropping pinnacles, where can you get plus ones, where can you get plus twos, and so forth. And then we're going to talk about some spoiler heavy stuff, so I'm giving you the warning now. And before I get to that section in the video, I also will pause and stop and say, alright, you might want to tap out here. The reason being is I kind of teased it in this morning's video, and a few of you guys in the comment section wanted to know what the spoilers were, and they're pretty mind-blowing, I'll tell you that right now. We're going to have some crazy things happening this season, so we'll go through that later in the video. But yeah, yesterday I was just working on the weekly challenges because I did not know what to do and what not to do when it came to pinnacles. I kind of got some things like, let's say for the strikes, I did like two of the strikes. I didn't complete all three strikes. For Gambit, I did two of the Gambit matches, not all three. I did not do the Deepstone Crypt raid. And yeah, we'll get into it and I'll discuss everything because a really nice list was put together. And also Dylan from Bungie, the community manager, he also clarified something on Twitter. Alright, so let's get into the video, guys, and if you enjoy it, as usual, kindly hit that like button and leave me a comment to help out with the lovely YouTube algorithm. Alright, why does my voice keep cracking? Alright, let's get into it, guys. So, right now, we only have a power bump in terms of your actual gear to 320, so you can get plus ones and plus twos. So you can decide if you want to do plus ones or plus twos first. I personally, I'm going to do the plus ones first, and then I'm going to do the plus twos first. Some people like to do it backwards. I recommend getting the plus ones out of the way first. And then, well, you can kind of do it backwards too, where you do the plus twos first and then use the plus ones to fill in the gap, so to speak. But we're going to use another method to, or at least I'm going to use another method to fill in those gaps of where I'm deficient in things by doing plus twos first and then doing plus one second. But you let me know in the comment sections if I have it all wrong and you're doing it a different way. Shout out to Rise of Bacon. I will link Rise of Bacon's Twitter in the description. I have known you for a while now, sir. And then also, you see that bacon bits on the surface of my mind? What's that from? Remember that Eris Morn line? Fingertips on my mind. Okay, anyway. He put a nice Reddit thread together going over the plus twos, plus ones, retired pinnacles, possible bugs, future also. All right, so let's knock this out. So for plus ones, all right, I'm going to cover that first. Plus ones, open three conflux chests with key codes in Override. That's obviously the new seasonal mission. This is just my first run, so don't mind me here, okay? I literally had no idea what the heck I was doing. All right, the core playlist, right? So when it comes to three games of Gambit, Strikes, PvP, that will give you a plus one, or should give you a plus one. The Hawthorne Clan XP, that's going to give you a plus one also. So you might want to grab, or at least I'm grabbing those first before I tackle the plus twos. All right, moving along here with the plus twos, we have the 100K Nightfall. That will give you a plus two. The Master Empire Hunt. Keep in mind, the Master Empire Hunt will be 1340 power, pretty high. I'm not going near that just yet. The Exo Challenge, that will give you a plus two. The Harbinger mission, if you want to get yourself a plus two primary, the Hawk Moon mission, that will give you a plus two. Prophecy Dungeon, only the boss clear, okay? The rest of it's not going to give you any plus twos, only the boss clear, okay? Trials of Osiris, coming this weekend, that will give plus twos. And of course, Iron Banner. Last seasons will drop at last season's cap. Now, if you haven't noticed already, if you kept the bounties like I recommended in my prep guide, supposedly those bounties that you kept from last season are dropping this new season's Iron Banner weapons. Let me know in the comment section if you got anything cool. I did not have any of those bounties. I did not play Iron Banner at all last season. I haven't played PvP in a very long time, except last week I played a little bit of Mayhem for the Pinnacle, and that was it. Now, clarification, retired Pinnacles, the Presage from last season to get the Dead Man's Tale, that's not going to give you a Pinnacle drop. Also, Deepstone Crypt, even though it's labeled on your director that it gives Pinnacles, it's not. We have a tweet from Bungie, from Dylan from Bungie. So we've identified an issue where some activities are advertising pinnacle drops when they are no longer rewarding them. Deepstone Crypt, the raid, should be granting at-power rewards at this time. Vault of Glass, that's going to give you pinnacle rewards when it goes live. So you can actually use Deepstone Crypt once you've completed all your plus ones and plus twos to maybe fill in some gaps. He also says we are currently investigating alternative pinnacle sources dropping items below expected power. Please let us know what you're seeing and we can pass it on to the team. Now, Rise of Bacon in his thread also posted a possible bug is the 8 Splicer Servitor Bounties. And I know Spencer, I was playing with him, channel member. He cashed them in last night and he did not get a pinnacle or even powerful, I think. Also, it shows as pinnacle on the app and also in-game the seasonal weapon quest, the fusion rifle, the null composure. I think there's a bug with that one. So, yeah, it looks like Vault of Glass will be the new source for the raid pinnacles, and I would just use Deepstone Crypt maybe to fill in the gaps if you want. Also, he says there's a possible seasonal mission later on that could give you a pinnacle. I will tell you right now, in some of the leaks, there are some... I'll just leave it at that. Something's definitely coming, okay? Don't want to talk about it just yet. But right now, we're going to get into spoiler territory, and we can burn through this rather quickly because it's just a few points. But here we go, guys. You ready? Tap out right now if you do not want to know any spoilers. Ready? One, two, three. Here we go. So our good old friend Ginzer over on Twitter and also Raid Secrets, he dumped a whole huge bunch of text coming out of, his data mining, basically. And over on Reddit, we've got an awesome Reddit thread, which I will link in the description, called Insane News in the Ginzer Text Dump. And it's an enormous text dump, but in this Reddit thread, he kind of summed up the main points that you need to know, which are all major spoilers. So let's burn through it. So let's take a look at this image right here, or images. And does that look familiar? Well, good old Quaria. This was tweeted out by Mont Even. I'm going to link Mont Even in the description on Twitter. He also does some data mining and posts images like this here. But let's burn through this here. So Quaria is responsible for the Endless Night. Well, that's what we're experiencing right now. And we defeat her at some point. If we kill her is not specified in the text. Also, we complete an override mission in the last city as the Vex attacks. So it looks like we will have an override mission in the last city at some point. Because right now the roadmap does not show override in the last city, but when we look at the roadmap at the very end, it does this epilogue and we do see them looking at the last city. So it looks like we're going to have an override mission there. I will tell you this, there will be no more faction rallies, or at least I'm believing from what I'm about to tell you, yeah, probably no more faction rallies, no more faction anything. So, Lakshmi, well, you know, she's a big character this season right now. Well, Lakshmi leads a coup against the Vanguard from her hatred of the Fallen, opens up a Vex portal in the Fallen quarter of the city to kill them as she believes they will further the Endless Night, and that's why we complete an override mission in the last city. And guess what, guys? Major, major spoiler right here. Lakshmi dies in the Vex invasion. So, yeah, she'll be dead. And also, all the factions have left the city. So, looks like, yeah, no more faction rallies, no more faction anything. They'll be leaving at some point, and Lakshmi too, she dies. Next up, Kaedle. Is it Kaedle? I always forget which one it is, Kaedle or Kaedle. Speaks to Zavala after the coup attempt, backing him up with the usual Cabal bluster of being a great warrior, and alliances are growing stronger as we go. Sane 14 vows to protect the House of Light, and Osiris, well, he's missing after the whole coup/Vex invasion fiasco. So, yeah, he's going to take off, and we're not going to know where he goes. Now, I will also link the full, well, I'm going to say a couple of thousand lines of text that Ginzer data mined in the description. Feel free to go through it if you want, but those are the key points, and yeah, kind of bummed out that Lakshmi 2 dies. I mean, I'm a diehard Future War Cult fan since Destiny 1, and We'll be sad to see her go, and it kind of sucks that the factions are leaving. So let me know what you think in the comments section about the factions leaving. That's kind of the main thing that I want to get your feedback on. So that's it for the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Leave me a good old hashtag, made it to the end. If you did make it to the end, and do me a favor, drop a like in this video only if you see fit. Follow me on Twitter at MesaSean. Check out my stream. Usually know it's on YouTube, and that's it. I am out of here like Vladimir.